Let's make this flower today. So you need 100% cotton yarn for this, and 1.5 millimeter crochet hook I'm going to use, pair of scissors, and the yarn needle. That's it. Let's get started. Now first of all, make a magic circle. And we have to make a slip stitch to the magic circle to secure it. So insert the hook into the magic circle, grab the yarn, pull through, grab the yarn and pull through the loop. So this is the magic circle. So we need to work 10 single crochet inside this magic circle. I will show you one how to do. So insert the hook into the magic circle, grab the yarn, pull through, grab the yarn and pull through. So just like the same, we have to complete 10 single crochet inside this magic circle. So complete it and meet me back. Now I have just completed 10 single crochet inside the magic circle. So we are going to close the magic circle by pulling this tail. And then close the first round by making a slip stitch to the first stitch we have done over here. Insert the hook into the first stitch, grab the yarn, pull through the stitch and pull through the loop. So now we have completed the first round. So we are going to start the second round. Now chain 3. This is going to be as a double crochet on the second round, and then chain another 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is going to be the space. So then again you need to make a double crochet to the next stitch. So grab the yarn and insert the hook into the next stitch, grab the yarn and pull through the stitch, grab the yarn and pull through 2, grab the yarn and pull through 2. So we have done one petal here. You need to make a double stitch to the next stitch. Grab the yarn and insert the hook into the next stitch. When you are working, make sure that you are working over this tail. Grab the yarn and pull through the stitch. Now you have 3 loops on the hook. Grab the yarn and pull through 2. And grab the yarn and pull through 2. Then again, chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And double crochet to the next stitch. Grab the yarn and insert the hook into the next stitch. Grab the yarn and pull through. Now you have 3 loops on the hook. Grab the yarn and pull through 2. Grab the yarn and pull through 2. Now we have done 2 petals. Just like the same, you have to complete all 5 petals. So you need to do another 3 petals and meet me back again. Now I have completed up to the last petal. So you can see here the tail is still remaining. So it has gone around now. So you can just cut that off. Like this. And we'll do the last double crochet to the next stitch. And then you have to put a slip knot to the third chain from here. Now we have completed the second row. and then we will start the third row. So you need to do a single crochet first to this chain space. So insert the hook into the space, grab the yarn, pull through. Now you have two loops on the hook, grab the yarn and pull through two. Now you have to do four double crochets to the same space. So grab the yarn, insert the hook into the space, grab the yarn, pull through. Now you have three loops on the hook, grab the yarn and pull through two, grab the yarn and pull through two. Now we have completed the first double crochet into the chain space. Now I will do three more. One, two, and three. Now to the chain space we have done one single crochet and four double crochets, and then chain three and put a slip stitch to the first chain over here. And make another four double crochets into the same space. One, two, three, and four. Then again you have to make a single crochet to the corner, and we have completed the first petal. So the next petal you're going to start by making a single crochet like this, and then four double crochets, chain three, slip stitch, another four double crochet and a single crochet. Just like the same, you can complete all five petals and meet me back. Now I have completed all five petals, and then what you have to do is to put a slip stitch to the next single crochet over here and grab the yarn and pull through and cut the yarn off. Now we have completed the flower. Now you can hide the tail. So take your yarn needle and insert the yarn needle into few stitches. Like this. And you can thread the yarn needle. And pull it from the other side, and then you can cut the yarn off. And we have completed the flower. If you like the video, just give it a thumbs up, and you can share the video, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.